Ja, den skal helst ned på gulvet.
Nå ja, det skal helst være øl eller sådan noget.
Welcome to this press conference. With us we have our national team coach Kasper Hjulmand and Martin Braithwaite, and we'll do a short introduction by Kasper, and then open for questions. When you ask in English, we'll answer in English. Og når I spørger på dansk, svarer vi på dansk. Kasper, vil du ikke sætte lidt ord?
Yeah, I think I'll do the first little part in English. So first of all, congratulations to England with the final. First of all, I want to congratulate my colleague Gareth. I followed what the FA has done strategically, and especially how Gareth has led this this team for a number of years now. How he works with the young players, how he gets involved, and how he behaves himself with the values he has, and how he represents and communicates. Is outstanding. So, congratulations, Gareth. I think you are doing a great job in a difficult job. So, congratulations. Ellers er vi jo dybt skuffet, hvis jeg sådan lige skal. Det er enormt svært for mig det her, fordi jeg har lyst til at perspektive, og jeg har lyst til at.
We're very, very disappointed, and it's hard for me to talk about this.
Egentlig har det måske om et døgn. Eller nogle timer.
Maybe it's easier for me to say how I feel in a few days. We're just very disappointed that we were so close. We were close to a final.
At det bliver afgjort på de omstændigheder.
And that it was decided that way. I've been reading the international press,
hvor bolden er ligger inde på banen og et straffe som ikke er der og så videre. Det er
and it was a penalty that shouldn't have been a penalty. So it's something that annoys me right now.
Så vi er skuffet. Vi er dybt skuffet.
So yeah, we're disappointed. We're very disappointed. Well, then there is the other part of me I can't describe with words how much I admire the technical staff behind these players. They have been through so much. We have two people from the staff who saved one of our best players' life. We have been fighting like crazy. We played good football.
Til den her slutrunde. Og så taknemmelighed for Danmark.
And I'm grateful. Grateful for Denmark. The entire nation.
For støtten. Vi havde brug for opbakningen.
We needed the support. We needed the empathy. When that happened with Christian, so we've been receiving a lot of love and a lot of support, and it was very amazing to feel. Unfortunately, we didn't get to the final, but one thing is for sure is that we're gonna attack again, and our future is full of hope and belief. These guys are outstanding. And the whole nation can be proud. And keep giving them the love and the respect they deserve. They're an amazing squad that has done an amazing job, and they have made Denmark proud. So huge respect from me to these players. Fantastic, fantastic team. Thanks, Kasper. Let's start with some questions from Denmark. Martin, do you agree with Hjulmand that the team spirit and the game you showed in this Euro, is that something that gives you more hope for the future? Of course, there's no doubt that we just need to digest this right now, but of course we're going to attack again. We are proud, but we're extremely disappointed right now because we believe that we could go further. And the way we lost today makes it harder to understand why we lost. But of course, I have to be careful with what I say. We're disappointed, 100%. But once we get over this, we have an amazing group, and we can definitely do something great again. Thanks, Mikkel. Question, Mads Vilas.
Med det her straffespark. Der er to bolde på banen, og det viser sig også, at Kasper Hjulmand er så lys i øjnene.
Regarding the penalty, what do you think about the whole situation? How did that destroy this? I saw you complain to the referees.
5 seconds before at
5 seconds before
Sterling løber forbi en bold, der ligger inde på banen.
Before Sterling passes by that ball there.
Spillet af, da det senere er en bold på banen. Men du må ikke løbe forbi en bold, der ligger på banen, når den har
influence. And you cannot pass by a ball on the pitch that has so much influence on the game.
Jeg kan ikke se det. Jeg kan simpelthen ikke se det straf.
I couldn't see that penalty.
Jeg ved godt, at det lyder sådan lidt.
Det lyder. I know it sounds.
Jeg kan ikke lade være med at have det.
Sounds weird right now, but I cannot help having these feelings.
En ting er.
I think it's hard. And one thing is to lose a game. That happens, but losing this way is just a disappointment.
So,
because these guys have fought a lot.
So
it feels it's bitter. I think we have to digest this before we can describe these feelings. But it's a bitter way to leave a tournament. Patrick from TV2.
Tak. Ja, det er selvfølgelig et afgørende moment, som du har sat ord på her, Kasper, men hvis du ellers kan prøve at sætte lidt mere ud på, hvad det var, der blev afgørende i dag for.
Can you tell us what was decisive for this game today?
Ellers havde den været det.
The penalty.
Og så er der ikke til, så ikke til.
Otherwise, it would have been 1-1. And then I can say what would have happened.
Jeg synes, at vi kom til at løbe.
We lost some initiative during the second half. But I knew that it was a question about time before we found the calmness again.
Det er jo det, der er afgørende.
And of course, scoring a goal was the decisive thing.
Det er klart, at vi havde der er ingen tvivl om, at vi skal finde bolden noget mere i løbet af anden halvleg.
Of course, we had to find more space in the second half. We had to be more proactive on the midfield. But we played with a lot of intensity. And after Italy, we're the team with most shots on target.
Spille med så meget passion og så meget hjerte og.
So we have played with so much passion and so much heart and so much personality as a team and as individual players. So this group is amazing, but of course we are disappointed right now.
Søren
from Politiken.
Hvordan oplevede I situationen med Joachim Mæhl efterfølgende, som har spillet?
How did you experience the situation with Joachim Mæhl? He was one of the best players during the tournament.
Ja, jeg tror allerede, vi har svaret på det. Der er overhovedet ikke, der er ikke nogen at klandre for det, der, fordi der var ikke straffet.
I think we've answered that question. I don't think that was a penalty. And if it was, it had nothing to do with Mæhl. So we're not thinking that it has anything to do with Mæhl. And we don't even know who was whose fault it was, whether it was Mæhl or anyone else. But it was an amazing experience, and I think that's what people are going to remember this for.
Javier from Süddeutsche Zeitung.
Yeah, I have one question for Martin. Martin, bearing in mind what happened today, bearing in mind the crowd, the atmosphere in the stadium, bearing in mind what happened with the penalty, if you had an Italian friend who to play on Sunday, what would you tell him?
Sorry, I didn't get the question.
What would you tell if you had a if you had an Italian friend who was due to play a final in Wembley in a similar atmosphere? What would you tell him, bearing in mind the crowd, the atmosphere in the stadium, and the penalty you received in the end of the game?
I just tell him to go and play the game, because that's what we did today, and we almost won. Just the penalty decided the game, so I would just say they have to go and play the game.
Thank you. Gabriel from ESPN.
Yes, Saturday.
Congratulations. I'm not going to ask about the penalty. I had the impression that you made a lot of changes earlier in the game, and after playing extremely well right up until sort of the end of the 90 minutes, maybe you lost a little after that. Was that a function of players being tired? The trip to obviously the trip back from Baku, was that a factor? And would you still make those changes when you made them?
The only one, of course, is the last one, where after the penalty kick, I had one left. So after the penalty kick, there was 15 minutes left. We played with three centre backs. I took off Yannick and put a striker in. So we played 4-3-3 in our normal system. And just the minute after, Matthias was injured and was taken out. So we played with 10. It's incredible that happened. But you can always say, should have done that. The others, there was a lot of struggles. Delaney had an injury. Andreas Christensen had an injury. He had to go out. There was a lot of tired legs. So some of them were, I think only one of them was actually, you know, a player who could play more. The rest was a lack of intensity.
Thank you. Vi tager de sidste 2-3 spørgsmål her. Patrick igen fra TV2. Patrick, værsgo.
Martin, det er et spørgsmål til dig.
Martin, a question to you.
Du skal i sig hjem og ikke videre. Det endte ikke med det her store kub, ligesom det også
gør. You're going home now. You're not going any further. It's been 3.5 weeks since the first game. How have these weeks been for you? You know, right now we're just very, very disappointed. We have been through a lot of great things and have experienced a lot of great things, but right now we're just feeling the disappointment. The support has been amazing. We felt how the whole nation supported us. It's been emotional for the entire team. And it's amazing to be Danish and to be part of this, but right now we're all disappointed. We wanted to be in that final. So this is a great, great disappointment. Mikkel from Ritzau.
Jeg vil bare gerne have begge to til at sætte nogle ord på den præstation, som Kasper Schmeichel leverer i dag.
Can you both describe Kasper Schmeichel today? He seemed to be doing everything in order to get you to the final.
Fantastisk i dag.
Altså, Kasper was amazing.
Han har igennem hele turneringen sådan løftet og løftet.
Throughout the whole tournament, he has been a key player, and he made some amazing saves tonight, and then he had that fighter energy. He would be able to do anything. I think he would even run up and try to score.
Ja, desværre var det ikke nok, men gjorde i hvert fald
unfortunately that wasn't enough. But his job was done. He did it fantastically.
Ja, Kasper, det var...
Martin, do you have anything to add?
Det er vildt nok at sige, men det skulle bare som det plejer. Altså han holder sig altid i et kamp.
No, it's crazy to say, but it's just
minder ham have en dårlig kamp.
It's just as it always is. I don't remember him playing any bad game. Of course, I always remember the goal scorers and the keepers get a little forgotten, but he makes a lot of saves, and I know he's going to continue doing that. It's important to have great players, but a good goalkeeper is crucial as well. He's an amazing goalkeeper.
Jonas
from Bold.
Tak for det.
Thank you.
Jeg kunne godt tænke mig at høre lidt om oplevelsen ved at komme herover på Wembley og spille.
Can you tell us about the experience of coming here to Wembley?
Som I har kaldt de sidste alle kampe i EM. Hvordan var det at spille her på Wembley og
havde How did it feel to play here at Wembley? Did that affect the game?
For mig er det bare fedt. Altså det er ikke
For me it's just cool.
Det er det ene eller det andet. Det altså
Whether we play at one stadium or the other, it's cool. It's okay.
Den ene halvdel havde været rød og hvid, og den anden havde været med engelske fans, men det var
of course I would have loved to have equal amount of England, fans and this was a home game for England because they had so many fans here, but that motivated us. So if you want me to say that it's because of that that they had so much advantage, I can't say that. But of course, we would have loved 30,000 Danes here. I agree with Kasper. As a football player, you want to play in front of fans because that they make it special to be a footballer. And playing without fans is not the same. We're just happy that we can have them at the stadiums. But of course, we would have wanted more Danes here at a semi-final. And yeah, you can playing home can have an effect on the game. But of course, I have to be careful with what I'm saying. Last question, Stefan.
Ja, hej. Den her, først og fremmest til Kasper.
Kasper,
var det her en once in a lifetime situation?
Was this a once in a lifetime situation? Being so close to a final? What do you think about that?
Det ved man jo aldrig. Altså slutrunder er
jo
finurlige. Der kan ske mange ting.
A lot of things can happen in these tournaments.
De her knockout kampe er jo meget lige. Men min fornemmelse
these knockout games are very equal. But I think that we can do it again. I have the sensation that we're going to be even better. And just when we, once we are over this and when we meet again in September,
we
are going to reflect on this.
England var også i en semifinale sidst.
Of course, England were in the semifinal last time, and now they're here again, and I believe in our team, and I believe we can do even more as well, but we never know. A lot of things can happen in the knockout games, from draws to minor details. That's just football. But I believe that great things are ahead with this team. That's how we're going to end this press conference. Thanks, everyone.